Welcome back. And if it is not already the case, you can sit back into a comfortable position. A position in which you feel at ease. In which it is easy for you to smile and be happy. And as you were previously doing, let go of every other kind of distractions that could pull your mind away. Let go of any tension. Any discomfort in the body, loosen up and smile. And however this manifests to you, you can start bringing up or generating the feeling of love or care, goodwill. No need to force, no need to push. But more it is by relaxing and letting go of everything else, of even trying to put a lot of effort into the feeling. That the feeling has more space to grow and to bear its real potential. And smile. Notice how good it feels, however the feeling feels for you, whether it is stronger or less strong. Notice how good it feels to feel this genuine goodwill for all living beings. Not holding a grudge for anybody. How relieving. The Buddha, in fact, said that this is one of the places to look for our happiness. Aweda, non-anger or loving kindness. And if your mind is making all sorts of judgments or opinions or critics about what you should be feeling or how your experience should feel like, just laugh. Mind is crazy. Takes things so seriously. Keeping us from just enjoying this simple moment. By laughing at whatever hindrance arises for you, or learning to smile at it, you are taking away all of that hindrance's power. And it becomes very weak and it dwindles right away. Just another hindrance. We meditate like the sun, the sun is not thinking about pushing its light into the universe, it just is. Similarly, we only need to bring up the feeling of love. Whatever tiniest bit it is. And simply this. Will slowly start to shine out. As long as we allow it to. Very simple. And remember that smiling will really help you and make you progress much stronger and faster on this path. The Buddha said it word for word. Sukhino cittang samadhiyati. And the happy mind becomes collected. Therefore, smiling is central. It will always keep us in the right direction. As soon as the smile fades away, or we notice it is gone, we can start wondering what the mind is doing. And even if we don't believe in it at first, it will slowly make its way to us. And we will become believers in the smile. And this works the same way if you're practicing any of the Brahma Viharas, whether it's compassion or joy, even boundless calm. We tend to make these complicated, but they're in fact very simple. a mind might come up with all kinds of excuses. What is this meditation about? I can't practice. When is it gonna end? Why am I doing this? I can't meditate. Don't believe the voices in your head. Just smile. All of these we simply call hindrances. They hinder us in our practice of boundless happiness and love. The reason why we stop meditating is because we start believing in what these voices are saying. And right here and now we are meditating and everything is fine. If one were to simply sit back, relax, smile, and just do that, they would already be successful in keeping on cultivating this. And inevitably, just by smiling and relaxing, the mind has no choice but to calm down. We simply have to be a little patient. Whatever arises in your mind, remember, keep it simple. Love, let go. Smile. beginning it might seem. A little more difficult, like the feeling is breaking up very often, and it's hard to really truly know whether or not this works. But as we persist and persevere and continually devote ourselves we notice that the times in between when the metta is breaking and the mind is flowing to distractions getting a little bit shorter every time. Every day. And the hindrances slowly start to lose their power. And it comes a point where we do experience and feel this steadiness. But we need some faith at the beginning. Saddha. Conviction. That we can do it. I tell you, this path works. You can do it. Anybody can. here are some direct instructions from the Buddha. Monks abandon unwholesome states and be relentless in cultivating wholesome ones. This is how you will come upon growth, increase, and prosperity in this Dhamma and virtuous way of life. Just as if there was, close to a village, a great sultry grove, covered in castor bean plant, a creeper. Then someone would come up, wanting it to live, wanting it to thrive, wanting its liberation. That person would cut down the saplings that were frail, crooked, and drawing sap, and wouldn't bring them away, completely clearing the inner grove. And that person would carefully tend to the young saplings, which were strong and upright. Then the sultry grove would quickly come to growth, increase, and prosperity. In the same way, monks, abandon unwholesome states and be relentless in cultivating wholesome ones. This is how you will come upon growth, increase, and prosperity in this Dhamma and virtuous way of life. Whatever happens to you, monks, you should train. Our minds will be unshaken. And we will not retaliate with hurtful words. We will dwell with a heart full of love. Caring for all living beings' well-being. Not obsessed by anger. We will dwell, suffusing that person with a heart filled with love. And with this as a support, we will dwell, suffusing the all-encompassing universe with a heart filled with love, vast, expansive, boundless, without anger, without resentment. This is how you should train. can be tricky. It can take our attention away very often without us realizing it. Whenever you stop smiling and you notice perhaps, oh, you're thinking about all kinds of things, just smile. You got cut again. Relax. Let go of any tension that might have built up. And bring up whatever vehicle you were using, whether it's the metta or the joy. The content of the hindrance doesn't matter. We treat them all in the same way. We let them go, we smile, and we come back. sabba mangalam rakkhantu sabba devata sabba buddhanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkhantu sabba devata sabbe dhammanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkhantu sabba devata sabbe sanghanu bhavena sada sutti bhavantu te. May all blessings be with you, and may all the devas protect you. By the powers of all the Buddhas, may you be well and happy. May all blessings be with you, and may all the devas protect you. By the powers of all of the Dhamma, may you be well and happy. May all blessings be with you, and may all the devas protect you. By the powers of all the Sangha, may you be well and happy. Sadhu.